So what is a telestrator? Well, it's a thing they use in sports to illustrate a point. They say this play went over this way. But I mean, I don't know anything about sports, but I have made a telestrator. So this is the screen of my iPad, which just I'm just pulling this in front. And this is running my app, which is called Shoot, which you can find more about at shootpro.app. With Shoot, you can draw on the screen. We can just say hello. So we can say, yeah, right, took him here, and then he's gonna go this way, and then we're all sorted. And that's basically what the telestrator is for. So when would you use this? Well, let's say you just wanted to make a point, you wanted to draw a molecule or something, and say there's some hydrogens, and there's a oxygen, and they're gonna be connected, and then they're gonna do something. You can just illustrate a point, or anytime you're talking, it's quite useful to have something up there. So how do you use this? Well, in this case, I've just got this plugged straight into my Mac, straight into Ecamm Live, which is, it's the easiest way to do it, but it does mean that you'll see the overlays reflected onto the screen, which is useful in this situation because I want to show you the overlays, but most of the time you'll plug through HDMI or Air Server. So wirelessly is actually works really well, but otherwise HDMI through an ATEM Mini or something like that. And then that's going to give you the best experience using the telestrator. So coming back to my face here, I'll show you how you turn it on. So by default, you will see this. Well, I can illustrate it by pointing at it, can't I? So here's the icon, a little squiggly drawing tool. So you can just tap on that and that will enable the drawing. And you can select a color down here and you can just draw directly on top of whatever's coming through to the camera. And if you wanted to do the back camera, I'll risk this. You can, you know, switch the cameras. So if you wanted to show something that was behind, you could do that. Say you were drawing something a bit more complicated, like, I don't know, the blue sky, and the sun is there, and you want to do a tree, and you end up getting, and then you sort of end up sort of wanting to draw some dots. Now, double tapping is going to clear the picture, and if you did do that by accident, you can click undo down here. So if you just do undo, that's going to bring back what you had before, and in fact, it's going to sort of reverse back through it. So you've always got that undo option, and there. What you saw happen there is, if say your background's quite light or there's quite a lot going on, like in my background, there's another icon here which lets you just fade everything out, and then you can really draw a clear picture and really sort of hammer your point home. And so that's really useful for that, and just double tapping will just bring everything back again. Let's say we wanted to come and sort of make a point about something up here. It might be quite hard to draw on it without the camera moving about, but you can just, there's a button here which is freeze frame, or you can just do a two finger tap with two fingers at once, and that's just going to freeze it. And now you can hear me still, but you can see that this is frozen, and we can draw around to our heart's content. Double tap to clear, double tap again is going to bring us back. So that's really useful if you just do want to talk over something. Maybe you're showing the picture-in-picture from your other camera. What else? There's just one last little gotcha. If you do try and tap to draw a dot, that's not going to work when you're connected over USB, because the tap is what hides and reveals the controls. But if you are connected over HDMI or AirPlay, then you can dot things without having to sort of do a little squiggly thing like that. Shoot is available in the App Store. You'll need to unlock what I'm calling premium updates to use the drawing feature, but the icon will appear and it'll let you have a play with it just so you can see if it's for you and if it all works. And you can also download the app for the whole app. And really, it's a camera using your phone or iPad as a camera. This also works on your phone just as easily, but it's a bit easier to demonstrate on an iPad. And the picture will usually be better than you were seeing there, because this is an old iPad mini. But that's another good thing about Shoot. You can use your old devices. So I hope you found that interesting. Let me know how you use it in the comments. And once again, that's shootpro.app. And you can find out all about the app there. Thanks for watching. Bye.